I've been really enjoying the extra content that Impact Wrestling has been putting out lately. I think for a long time, us fans have been hoping to get some kind of second show here in the United States. And that's kind of what these serve as. When it comes to the Global Wrestling Network, I wasn't too big on pulling up the old content. I think for the most part, I was watching it for the featured match on Explosion and then for the Around the Ring segments as well. I rarely sit there and pull up the old pay-per-views, and I haven't really been too big on some of the indie stuff that they put up. The one-night-only shows, however, I think are the first major piece of content that's really making the Global Wrestling Network worth the monthly purchase or the monthly subscription. We've had three shows so far, the one-night-only in Oklahoma, the Canadian Clash, and the March Breakdown. As I said earlier, I think in the U.S. we've been wanting a second show for a while, and these one-night-onlys really give us that. The one-night-onlys before were very promo-heavy, and while the matches lasted a little longer, they were oftentimes kind of boring, and the crowd wasn't into them. A lot of the times for the one-night-onlys, they did matinee tapings in the Impact Zone, and those daytime shows are the ones that are really tourist-heavy. I say it all the time, I never felt, you know, Impact episodes were as tourist heavy from my experience being there, as like the dirt sheets will make it seem, but the one night onlys were typically let's get people from the park to fill out the crowd. So it was usually like you could hear a pin drop in there. Ed Norholm really delivered when he said that the one night onlys would be taken more seriously in 2018. I just finished the March Breakdown and it was an excellent show. I'm really enjoying these partnerships much more than if it was just a traveling Impact house show. You know, they help Impact cut costs. It places them in markets that already like wrestling and already have a fan base. It helps these independent shows put on a special event, and then it helps put them in front of new eyes as well. Good thing for Impact, they can scout talent who would probably be more loyal to them if they were signed because of the early exposure the company gave them. And it's also getting these guys more, you know, Twitter followers. As we find new stars we like, we're tweeting at them, and these stars are eating it up. You know, some of these guys, Cody Deaner and, you know, this action adventure dude from the March Breakdown, you know, people are really enjoying these guys, and it's just a great win-win business model. And these Canadian shows have had Alicia from Ambi doing the backstage segments. She's absolutely gorgeous, number one, and she's really good at what she does. So you don't have to bring Mackenzie Mitchell all the time. You bring someone who has an internet presence and is known, you know, in Canada, for instance, already. So they're giving people work. It's really good stuff. Now, when they're not recording one night only, they're doing content for Twitch, like the recent Last Chancery show. Now, Twitch initially kicked off with the Barbed Wire Massacre 3, which was genius marketing, in my opinion. And these shows in general, these house shows, even the one-night-onlys, in general, allow them to take some extra risks, like putting Kongo Kong in the main event, getting Braxton Sutter some heel time on the mic, and experimenting with how they want to present the Desi Hit Squad. The Twitch content like Last Chancery and Brace for Impact have been really solid, although I think the knock has been the viewing experience and the quality. These are house shows, and they're not going to pay TV camera crews from Orlando or anywhere else for that matter, to come in and film what's free content for us. Now, Impact, from what I'm understanding, does have a financial agreement with Twitch, but this isn't a platform where they're making a whole bunch of revenue, or at least I would imagine they're not. I'd imagine they're not receiving, you know, ad revenue, because you can do ad revenue, which ad revenue is not a lot. It's usually like a penny per click or something like that, for streaming format, that is. I would imagine they're not doing ad revenue, but that there was an initial monetary agreement similar to how Impact cuts deals with their stars for merchandise, giving them that lump payment up front that probably equals the less money than they would receive in royalties over the long run, but it's an upfront lump sum. So the viewership on Twitch has been decent so far, but it would be nice to see at least triple by year's end. I mean, with 25,000 subscribers, I'd like to see more than 1,500 live streams for the big events. 3,000 on-demand streams. You know, like I would just like to see those numbers really triple by the end of the year. I like the 24-hour content. It's similar to like what Pluto TV does. And as I said, I don't like to pull up the old Global Force, I mean, the Global Wrestling Network stuff, the GWN stuff, or the old stuff on GWN. But I think on Twitch, it's fun to log on and see what's playing. And the moderators on Twitch, there's trolls, don't get me wrong. But the moderators on there do a pretty good job of keeping the trolls out. So just remember, these are their house shows. We're watching them for free, so you're not going to get a TV quality product. But for what they are so far, I really enjoy them. So let me know in the comments, what have you guys thought about Impact on Twitch, the Global Wrestling Network One Night Only shows? And I think it's safe to say that Impact Wrestling versus Lucha Underground is going to be the one that really brings in the viewers and the subscribers to Twitch. I think that's going to be huge. It's something everyone really wants to see. It's going to bring in a lot of Lucha Underground fans. So great stuff, guys. Great stuff, Impact Wrestling. So let me know what you guys think so far in the comments about Twitch and the GWN. Talk to you soon. Peace.